Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to our service this month. I'm sorry that we didn't get one at the beginning of the month, but I was just a bit too busy. But I did say I would do one on Remembrance Sunday and actually make it about remembering our loved ones. So it's a service of thanksgiving for those that we've known and loved. It is also Remembrance Sunday, as I said, and so we're also going to remember those who died in all of the wars, World Wars 1 and 2, and all the many other wars that we've had over the years. So we remember them too. But there are lots of remembrance services out there, online or on the television. If you want to watch a traditional remembrance service, then I suggest that's what you do. Otherwise, stay with us and we will have a service of remembering our loved ones. So we come today to remember with thankfulness those we have known and loved who have died. We give thanks for all that they have meant to us. We come seeking to learn of God's love and to open our lives to the help and strength that He can give us as we continue on the journey of life without them. We pray for ourselves and all who mourn that they would be comforted. And so now we're going to sing our first hymn, and our first hymn is Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. So let's sing. And so now our opening prayer. Eternal God and Father, we praise you that you have made people to share life and to reflect your glory in the world. We thank you now for those whom we come to remember today, for all that we saw of your goodness and love in their lives, and for all that they have meant to us. As we too journey towards death, may we do so in the company of Jesus, who came to share our life, that we might share the life of eternity. To him be glory with you and the Holy Spirit, for ever and ever. Amen. So now we're going to have two Bible readings and I'm going to read them. It's a one-man show today. So I'm going to read the Bible readings and we're starting with Psalm 121. I lift my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time and forevermore. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So now we have our second reading, and it's from Romans chapter 8, beginning at verse 31. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, how will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ who died, or rather was raised, who is also at the right hand of God, who also intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will affliction or disease or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than victorious through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So as I've said already, we come today to remember those we have loved and who have died. We come with all sorts of feelings and emotions, and it's right that we acknowledge them now. Feelings of loss can be so mixed and varied, because we're all different, we all react differently, our feelings will be different. For some, the feelings will be those of anger, whilst for others, it may be tranquility, peace. Some may feel empty and lost, whilst others feel fulfilled at having known them and have begun to find their way forward. For some of us, those feelings will still be very raw, whilst others may have learned how to live with or around them, and life has moved on. Whatever stage you are at, there may be days when the grief and sadness overwhelm you, and you ask yourself how you can ever move on and who can help you. In that reading from the Psalms, it asks that very question. I lift my eyes to the hills, where does my help come from? And then very helpfully, it goes on to say, my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. And it's true. God is there and he will always offer us his help. It is up to us to accept it. The psalm then goes on to tell us that God is there with us at all times, and he will not let anything harm us. Then in our second reading, which was from Paul's letter to the Romans, which was written hundreds of years later, we're told the same thing. God in Jesus is there for us, and nothing can separate us from him. Amazing, isn't it? That no matter when we need him, God is there. He never leaves us. And all we have to do is reach out to him. He doesn't mind that we haven't noticed him before or that we haven't really believed in him. He just wants us to open our hearts to him and allow him to be there for us. So if you are worried that you don't know how to do that, but feel that you want to, well then please do send me a message and I'll try and help. Or speak to someone who might be able to help, because I'm sure that they would happily walk alongside you as you discover the wonderful truth about who God is and what he has to offer you. Because I know he just wants to fill you with his love and peace. In that letter, Paul tells us that God is always on our side, and nothing, absolutely nothing, can touch us when we believe in him and follow in his ways. It says that neither death nor life can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. And that in itself is powerful enough. But it goes on to say that not even angels, rulers, things present or things to come, powers, height or depth can separate us either. And if that isn't enough to reassure us, he finishes with, nor anything else. Paul really did mean that nothing can separate us from God. As a Christian, I absolutely believe that. But there are times when I need reminding. And so I just read this passage to reassure myself that God is always there. Of course, I also read my favourite passage in the whole Bible, the end of Matthew's Gospel, when Jesus says that he will be with us to the end of the age. What more can we ask for? He's with us when things are good and when we are filled with joy. But more importantly, he is always there with us when things are not good and we're in trouble or pain. God is here with us right now. And as we remember those we have loved but who have died, and as we feel the pain of losing them, God is there waiting to wrap us in his arms and comfort us. All we have to do is reach out and invite him in. Maybe you don't come to him because you're afraid that you're not good enough. Trust me when I say that none of us are good enough. But God knows that, and he loves us anyway, warts and all. Jesus wants you to come to him and he wants you to experience the love he has for you. He wants to help you. He wants to be there for you. When you feel down, he wants to lift you up and give you hope. When you are angry, he wants to calm you and give you peace. When you are lost, he wants to guide you and give you wisdom. When you want to rant and rave at someone, he wants to listen and give you understanding. When you don't want to face the world, he wants to show you how you can and give you courage. And when the time is right and you don't feel the pain of your grief as sharply, he wants to rejoice with you and fill you with joy and happy memories of those you love. And then he wants to stay with you and help you to live the life that he has planned for you. You see, knowing and loving Jesus is not just for the bad times, but for all time. And so my prayer for those of you who don't know him is that you open your hearts to Jesus and get to know him. And my prayer for those of you who know and love Jesus is that you will just experience every day the amazing love that he has for you. So continue to be filled with his love, and that you show that love to others so that they too can experience it through you. So as we remember our loved ones this day, as we remember them and ask God to continue to take care of them, we also ask him to open our hearts, to allow Jesus to come in and to minister to us and to fill us with his love, grace, and peace. Amen. So now we're going to sing again, and this time we're going to sing "The Lord's My Shepherd." So let's sing. So now we come to our prayers, and this morning we remember before God our loved ones, and we're going to pray for those who grieve. So God of grace and glory, we come to remember those we have loved but see no more. We find it hard to let go of our loved ones and leave them in God's keeping. So as we remember the coming of Jesus at Christmas and await his return, we remember his words to us, "I am the resurrection and the life." And so this morning may it be a reminder of God's love for us and his invitation to each one to turn to him. So in your presence, Lord, we remember with thankfulness our loved ones departed this life. And so now I'm just going to read some names that you have given me. For those we know and love who have died: Jeremy Plummer, Rosemary Horman, Joan Lily Thomas, John Edwin Wigham, Brett Smith, Timothy Mann, Ronald Morris Chorley, Joy Webb, Theo Armstrong, Robert Munn, Betty Bennett, Mike Amphlett, Pete Marsden, Kerry Marsden, Sean Marsden, Kenneth Hum, Alan Roebuck, David and Beryl Wade, Cynthia Osborne, Dorothy Longdon, Harry and Margaret Rogers, John Wakefield, Mary Sykes, Warren Blizzard, Sue Pitchforth, Keith Hodgson, Mabel Blakeney. Loving Lord, we now take a few moments to be still. Help us to draw close to you and hear your word of peace, your invitation to faith in you. As in your presence, we remember our loved ones, those names we have read, and those who are close to us in our hearts. Loving Lord, we thank you that we were able to share a time in our lives with those we loved. Thank you for every precious moment that we shared and for the example of their lives. And we pray now for all those who grieve. We pray, Lord, for those who today are still struggling with the pain of grief. We pray for those who feel orphaned by the pain of the death of a parent or grandparent or someone who was like a parent to them. We pray for those who feel the silence and separation after the death of their husband, wife, or partner. We pray for those who have suffered the untimely loss of a son or daughter, those who face the pain of miscarriage and stillbirth. We pray for those whose loved ones died suddenly and unexpectedly through ill health, accident, suicide, tragedy, malice, or war. We pray for those who sadly miss a good friend or relation. We pray for those who supported loved ones through terrible illness. And we pray for those who are supporting others in their grief. Loving Lord, we pray for all those who this day are grieving, those for whom tears flow freely, and those who struggle to grieve. Minister to each, we pray, out of the depths of your love, bringing them peace, comfort, and hope. And we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. And so we bring our prayers together with the words of the Lord's Prayer, led, as always, by members of our congregations. Let's pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread.
And forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
So now we're going to sing again, and this time we're singing How Great Thou Art. So let's sing this together.
Thank you.
Well, as our service comes to an end, I do hope that you have been able in this time to just think about loved ones who have already gone before us to the heavenly kingdom, and that as you've thought about them, they've brought back some good memories rather than pain. Something that you can think about for the rest of the day and smile as you remember them, because it's always good to smile when we remember someone. So I'll just chop it and put something in there. Loving Lord, we thank you that we were able to share a time in our lives with each of those. No, start that again. Loving Lord, we thank you that we were able to share a time in our lives with those we loved. Thank you for every precious moment that we shared and for the example of their lives. And we pray now for all those who grieve. We pray, Lord, for those who today are still struggling with the pain of grief. We pray for those who feel orphaned by the pain of the death of a parent or grandparent or someone who was like a parent to them. We pray for those who feel the silence and separation after the death of their husband, wife, or partner. We pray for those who have suffered the untimely loss of a son or daughter, those who face the pain of miscarriage and stillbirth. We pray for those whose loved ones died suddenly and unexpectedly through ill health, accident, suicide, tragedy, malice, or war. We pray for those who sadly miss a good friend or relation. We pray for those who supported loved ones through terrible illness. And we pray for those who are supporting others in their grief. Loving Lord, we pray for all those who this day are grieving, those for whom tears flow freely, and those who struggle to grieve. Minister to each, we pray, out of the depths of your love, bringing them peace, comfort, and hope. And we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. And so we bring our prayers together with the words of the Lord's Prayer, led, as always, by members of our congregations. Let's pray. And so now we're going to sing again, and this time we're singing How Great Thou Art. So let's sing this together. Well, as our service comes to an end, I do hope that you have been able in this time to just think about loved ones who have already gone before us to the heavenly kingdom, and that as you've thought about them, they've brought back some good memories rather than pain. Something that you can think about for the rest of the day and smile as you remember them, because it's always good to smile when we remember someone. So now to our blessing. May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless and console you and all who have known those. Now we come to our blessing. Do that bit about da 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 da. Whatever it is. 1, 2, 3. So just before we come to our blessing, which will be obviously towards the end of our service, just to say that there will be a service next month, hopefully at the beginning of the month. I'm hoping I'll get that done. And I will also try and revamp the carol service. I'm not sure how, but I'm sure I'll find out how. I will try and revamp you the carol service so that you've got something for Christmas. So let's come to our blessing. May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless and console you and all who have known those whose memories we've honoured today. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those you love this day and always. Amen. So go in the light and peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. So I'll see you all again next week. And as we go, I'm going to leave you with a piece of music. So please do enjoy this and I'll see you next time. Bye. Bye.